A lot of word is found on the internet. A lot of people are doing videos on a word from the Lord. Some even make disclaimers by saying it's not meant for everyone, and there should be disclaimers. There should be warnings given to those viewers to seek a personal relationship with the Lord, and there are some who will emphasize that. But I'm noticing more and more word from the Lord that goes against his word. And when you see this happening, you have to go deeper into the word of God to make sure it's not something that you prefer to hear or not to hear, but it's something that the word of God is actually stating. And many people have a word from the Lord for the entire body of Christ that is contrary to what the word of God says. And I want to bring some clarity to those of you who see that it is not congruent with your life and everything that you try, that they say to try or to do, is not coming to pass in your life. And it's not going to, because it's going against the word of God. And specifically, what I would like to touch on today is the prospect that there's going to be prosperity in the land, and the children of God are going to be in certain situations where they will be the head and not the tail, and all of those things. And we know that God was speaking to Israel with that, and we are spiritual Israel. However, we do have to rightly divide the word of truth. And our dispensation, this dispensation of grace, does not warrant us being in the front and being victor over everything. We're victorious through Christ in our life and struggle with sin and fight in the world, but we don't fight flesh and blood. So what are we fighting? We're fighting principalities and powers and rulers of the darkness of this world and spiritual wickedness in high places. So I'm going to just share a few scriptures with you and a thought that I would like for you just to contemplate and to think about. And it's simply, if I were to give a topic to this, it would be prepare. You have to be prepared for what's to come. You are not living in the dispensation of the millennial reign of Christ. We are suffering for the name's sake of Christ. There are loads of scriptures, and I'm going to leave them some in the description, that tells us we are, if we don't suffer with Christ, we're not going to reign with him. Each of us have a purpose. And so all of us can't be categorized into one area. There will be people, and there are people who are rich, wealthy, and they are servants of the Most High God, and they are here to fund ministries. There are people who are here to care for orphans. There are people who are here to counsel the grieving. There are people who are here to help others and to teach others and to sharpen others. There are some people who their main purpose in life is to pray for others. There are people who are here to do all kinds of things, but none of us, we are many members in one body, and there's none of us that are supposed to have the same identical things. Yes, there will be some poor, righteous people. He called the poor rich in faith, the word says. Rich in faith. Everyone is not going to be wealthy. Everyone is not going to be poor. It's not a matter of what's right or wrong, good or bad. It's what our purpose is for. There are some people who will be wealthy and who are wealthy, but it's for the upbuilding of the kingdom. And if that's not God's plan for you, it doesn't matter how much word comes, how many people prophesy and pray over you. It doesn't matter what formulas you complete. It doesn't matter how many seeds you sow. If it's not your purpose to be a certain, have a certain wealth, you will not have it. You can't say, Lord, let your will be done in my life, and then tell him how to do it, because that's insanity. So I just want to leave that with you. All of us have a purpose. All of us need to prepare. But all of us will suffer for the name's sake of Christ. If we are godly, we shall suffer persecution. How that is manifest, it depends case by case. Some people may have lost a job. Some people may lose status in the community. Some people may be struck out on the streets. It doesn't matter how it happens. It's that it will happen. The righteous shall suffer persecution. If we don't suffer with Christ, we will not reign with him. We will not reign with him. But we have to understand and receive and realize that our suffering is just for a moment. The glory that shall be revealed outweighs anything that we can go through in this life. But to tell people and to fool people or to make people disillusion people by telling them that everyone who belongs to the Lord and everyone who lives godly is supposed to have a certain status or a certain income or a certain wealth or a certain whatever, that's not biblical. It's not biblical. The word that is being given today should ease the minds of those who have not received. Maybe it's not for you to have. Maybe it's for you to love even more, like it is for all of us. But maybe God is using you in a place. Think about it. And the word backs this up. If everyone is an eye, then where would the hearing be? If everyone is an ear, then where would the seeing be? So everyone can't have the same thing, because there will be guaranteed. There are people that if they had more money would not think about visiting a nursing home, would not think about visiting the sick, would not think about praying for anyone. And God is for the saving of the soul. He wants you with him eternally. And if he knows, because he knows all, that you are not going to be a good steward over riches, you're not going to have them. And I don't care who prays for you and who prophesies over you, you will not have it if it's God's will for you to be with him. He loves you that much that he will give you what you need. He said, if you seek his kingdom first, all those other things will be added. He's not going to forsake you. He's not going to leave you. He won't abandon you, but you are not going to have wealth, because your soul means more to him than your state at this moment. This may not seem like an encouraging message. It may not seem like an encouraging word, but it should give some relief to certain people who think no matter what they try or who they have come in contact with, I just can't seem to get off the ground. You may need to be on the ground to help those who fall to the ground. That just may be your call. It may be your call to be in a place where, and when someone has a problem, they can come to you and God gives you the wisdom to impart into them. Some of you, if it were not for your prayers, there are a lot of things would not be manifest in others' lives. But your prayers are rich and wealthy and carry weight in heaven. Some of you, God has allowed to take care of the sick and infirm because it brings the compassion that's in your heart out, where you would never know you had that compassion had you not been around sick people. Everyone has a purpose, and everyone is here for a reason. And your job is to find out from God directly why you were born and what your purpose is. And he will not leave you void. He will not leave you void. Always test what is being said to you by the word of God. No matter how many chills you get when you hear it, no matter how this person or that person seems to be anointed, if it's not congruent with the word of God, keep moving. God bless you. Until next time.